one of the biggest requests I get is, Daniel, when is Filmora going to bring motion tracking to any of their software? Well, today those requests have been heard and Filmora Pro introduces motion tracking. If you want to learn how to use this feature, stick around. I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
So the very first thing you want to do is open up Filmora Pro and let's bring in some footage. I'll start with this footage of some cars driving down the highway. Let's bring that over into our timeline. If you don't know what motion tracking is, it's the ability to take one of the elements in your project and have it follow something through that scene. So in this case, I've got this footage of these cars. Let's add a text element by clicking on the text tool. And up in the preview window, we'll write, Daniel. I'm an egomaniac, let's use my name. In the timeline, I'm gonna stretch that out so it covers the entire piece of footage for now. Now, if I double left click on that text track down in my timeline, in the upper left, you'll see that there are some options that open up. On the behaviors tab, let's click that plus button to the right. And in the window that opens up, let's type in motion tracking. We don't even need to complete that sentence before it knows what we're talking about. Left click on that and it now assigns motion tracking to this particular piece of text. I'm gonna change this font a little bit. So in the upper left, I'll click on the text tab. I'm gonna change the font to impact, which is one of my favorites. And let's change the text size to 100 just so it's a little bigger and easier to see. Now back in the controls tab, let's look at the motion tracking feature. The little arrow to the left of it, you wanna click on that. It'll open up this dropdown. Now the first option is motion from. That's Filmora Pro asking us, hey Daniel, what do you want this text to follow? We don't know what to assign it to. So we'll click on that particular tab and you'll see here in the dropdown, the only option I have is video one cars clip because that's all that's in the project. Let's select that. What this does is Filmora Pro is going to start analyzing this piece of footage and recognizing high contrast sections that it can track the motion of throughout the course of this clip. Once Filmora is done analyzing it, you'll see that it tells us to draw around the area you wish to track. So let's go back to our selection tool, and now you'll see that our footage has all these little X's around it. Some of these X's represent objects that aren't moving, and some represent objects that are. Let's select this red car here just by left-clicking and holding and circling around it. Do you see how those X's turn green? I've now told Filmora Pro these are the areas it needs to pay attention to. Let's move this text off to the right up here. And if I hit play, you'll see that my text now follows that car because those are the areas in this piece of footage that I told Filmora Pro were important. But did you notice how that text started rolling off funny? It started angling in a weird way. In the upper left, you can control the motion of that text. I'm gonna turn the rotation feature off because I want it to stay very flat and linear as it follows this car. And now you'll see it just tracks that car right off screen. Now, one thing you really need to understand is that it can only follow the X's that are in the scene. So if I were to take this text and put it up behind this car, the minute that car goes off screen before the text won't know what to do. So at that point there, what you would need to do if you wanted to leave the text in the upper left is you'd need to add some keyframes and tell the text to continue off screen once those reference points were gone. But an easy way around that is just put the text in a different location. I'm gonna make sure that the X's don't go off screen before the text does. Now in this case, the camera was stationary and the objects in the footage were moving, but we can also do this with footage where the camera is moving. Let's bring in a different piece of footage. This is some drone footage where everything on the ground is stationary, minus the waves, and the camera is flying overhead. Let's try adding some text to this tool as well. Let's click on the text feature just up under the upper right preview window. And there's a cool little cave. I'm gonna call that my cave. Let me stretch that text out in my timeline. And if I double left click on that, up in the upper left again, you'll see behaviors. We'll click the plus sign next to behaviors and find the motion tracking feature again. Let's left click on the arrow just to the left of that box. And once again, it'll ask us where we'd like to track the motion from. Let's choose the video logo section and it'll go ahead and analyze that clip as well. Once it's done analyzing, it'll tell me to draw around the area we wish our text to track. So let's click on that, go back to the selection tool. And let's choose this cave. There's a couple points right here, somewhere around this cave. If we hit play, you'll see that this now follows that cave. Now, the same thing happened. It started to rotate before I wanted it to. So let's turn off that rotation feature in the upper left. And if I hit play, now I not only have my cave, but I have my rock as well. Now, if you want to change the assignment in any way, you can either click on the Remove tab and deselect these areas. You can add new sections that you want it to track, or you can choose Replace and choose the area you'd like to follow now instead of what is currently selected. Really simple tools to make your motion tracking nice and easy. If you want to try Filmora Pro and this really cool motion tracking feature, I'll put links down in the description of this video where you can download and try this software today. And if you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, make sure you click on the videos on screen now and the ones I'll pin down below in the description in the comments. Peace.